Yes. The Azan, the Muslim call to prayer, 5 times a day, every day of the year. The Muazzin, he goes on top of the minaret. He goes on top of the minaret because in the good old days, we didn't have mic systems. Here we are doing from here, and the horns are carrying on the message from the outside, from the minarets. But previously, the Muazzin, poor man, he had to climb right to the top so his voice can travel. So he goes on top of the minaret and he shouts in a loud sonorous voice. He says, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, meaning Allah is the greatest, Allah is the greatest. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest, Allah is the greatest. 4 times. Then he says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, that I bear witness that there is no other object of worship but Allah. He repeats it twice. That the only one who deserves to be worshipped is him. He continues, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, I bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, I bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. He repeats it twice. If you accept these two fundamentals, that there is but one God, one Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger, then what is the message? The Muazzin continues, Sahayya ala salat, he said, come to prayer. Hayya ala salat, he said, come to prayer. Hayya ala al-falah, he said, come to success. Hayya ala al-falah, he said, come to success. Because this is real success. That you remind yourselves about your duties and obligations towards your Creator and your duties and obligations towards your fellow human beings. If you want to be successful, there is no other way. And he winds up the call by saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, that Allah is still the greatest. Allah is still the greatest. Whether you come or you do not come, you are not going to lower him in his exaltation, in his majesty, in his glory. He still remains supreme. And a final words of warning he gives, the Muazzin, he gives, La ilaha illallah, that there is no other object of worship but Allah. You can keep on worshipping your man gods, your money gods, your woman gods. But remember this, that the only one who deserves to be worshipped is Allah. This is the national anthem of the Muslims wherever they live. And when you hear the call, you do not have to ask who is ringing the bell. Like in Christianity, whether it's a Roman Catholic or a Dutch Reformed Church, is an RC or a DRC, you don't have to ask. You can hearken to the call. Whether you're in China, whether you're in Nigeria, whether you're in Turkey, whether you're in England, when you hear the call, you can hearken to the call. National anthem of the Muslims, wherever they live. Now, the one we worship, the one before whom we prostrate ourselves, we call him Allah. And as I said, Muhammad is not our Allah. We prefer this word Allah to the English word God. Because this English word God is often misused or misapplied. You see, in English, we are talking English, I'm speaking English. In English, we have a plural of gods. God is gods. God, and you have more than one, you say gods. You have a woman gods, you call them goddesses. You have a small gods, you call them godlings. Yes, that's English. You know, little gods, godlings. Whereas this Arabic word Allah is absolutely unique. You see, Arabic has its rules of grammar like any other language. But in Arabic, you can't make a plural of Allah, you can't make a feminine of Allah, and you can't make a diminutive of Allah. Unique word. Ask the Arabs. Ask them. Come on. I want a plural. See, in Arabic, can you say Allahs? Can you? Huh? Can you say a woman Allah? Can you say? I don't know. Like goddess. You see, this Arabic, this English word God, they speak about gods and goddesses who ate and drank, who wrangled and plotted, carried away the wives of other gods. In English, if you are looking after somebody's child as a guardian, they say you are a godfather to the child, and the woman, your wife, is a godmother to the child. This word is so abused, you can use it anyhow as you like. Allah Bari Ta'ala has preserved us from that. You can't do anything. We prefer this word to the English word Allah, our God. Now what you are doing now, you are giving him the concept. See, and again, we emphasize that Muhammad is not our Allah, because they are thinking that maybe we accept Christ as our Lord, God, maybe you accept Muhammad as your Lord, God. We have to assure them that we are not displacing Jesus Christ with Muhammad to say, Jesus is not God, but Muhammad is. We do not tell you that Jesus is not the Son of God, but Muhammad is the Son of God. We do not tell you that Christ didn't die for your sins, Muhammad died for your sins. No, we think nothing. We talk nothing of the kind. It's quite a different thing altogether. We are inviting you all to the worship of the one true God, the one that Jesus worshipped. And Jesus called him Allah. And they get the shock. I said, the name of God Almighty in your Bible is Allah. In the Semitic languages, in the language of Moses, Jesus and Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the name of God Almighty is Allah. But in your Bible, there is not a Bible in the world. The Christians have translated this Bible into 2,000 different languages. 2,000 different languages. And this word, Allah, is to be found in every language of the world. Amazing! You know, this is a miracle. It's a mu'jiza of a highest order. That in the New Testament of the Christians, Old and New, the Old New Testament, everything after Jesus, in the original manuscript, what they call original, in Greek, the word Jehovah is not there. There is a group of people, among the Christians, call themselves Jehovah's Witnesses, witnesses to Yahweh. They are really claiming to be the witnesses to Allah. That's what they're claiming. And they say the name of God Almighty is Jehovah. He says, you know, this word Jehovah, in the 27 books of the New Testament, there are 27 books. The word Jehovah is not there. In the original, it's not there. Amazing. And you ask them, when you meet them in the flesh, I said, who would be wanting to get rid of God's name? If this is his name, if the name of God Almighty is not Allah but Jehovah, all right, who would be wanting to get eliminate such a name? Who? So he'll tell you straight away, the devil. I said, right. Who's right? If the name of God is Jehovah, or the name of God Almighty is Allah, who would want to get rid of that word Allah? Who? Shaitan. It's logical. So I said, you see, in your 27 books, the word Jehovah is not there. And you say Jehovah inspired the books. Why would Jehovah himself, the inspirer, not want to have his name inside? Unless he's ashamed of his name. He must have done something horrible. Like Hitler. You know, he's ashamed. His own name. God Almighty is ashamed of his name. In the 27 books, not once. But in your books, the name Allah is there. The name Jehovah is not there in the 27 books. Not once. But Allah is still there. I said, where? I said, you see, you are looking at it. You see it. You utter it. You hear it. And you don't grasp it. It's an amazing situation. See, Allah says, ثُمُّ بُكْمٌ أُمْيٌ فَهُمْ لَا يَرْجِعُونَ.